السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to Quran Circle 5, where we listen to some of the verses in the Quran, focusing this time about the verses that talks about the universal signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These many verses in the Quran that talks about the creation of Allah. One of the ways of the Quran to establish the clear evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the creator of all things, to reflect upon these signs for people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, using these signs clearly that nobody can deny that these are amazing signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, humble yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worship Him alone. So we're going through these verses from one surah to the other, some of these verses that talks about the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned them in details, therefore we need to constantly purify our hearts with the recitation of these verses to reflect upon them by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it benefiting and for us to benefit from listening to the Quran and reflecting upon the meanings of it. And before we start, I would like to introduce the reciters that we have with us in this episode. We have with us Sheikh Mustafa Ahmadi from Afghanistan. Welcome to the program. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have also Sheikh Mas'ud Abdullah from Bangladesh. Welcome to the program.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa
barakatuh. And also we have Sheikh Fardeen Raoufi from Afghanistan. Welcome to the program.
Shukran.
Barakallahu fiik. And Sheikh Irsad Shahad from Afghanistan also. Welcome to the program.
I am glad to meet you. Thanks for your attention. Barakallahu fiik.
Inshallah, this is as we see. We have reciters from all over the world to recite for us and to listen and for us to reflect. We'll start inshallah ta'ala with verses in Surah Al-An'am, verse number 95 to 98 from Surah Al-An'am with Sheikh Mustafa Ahmadi. Please go ahead and recite for us.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Inna Allah faliqul habbi wan nawa. يخرج الحي من الميت ومخرج الميت من الحي ذلكم الله فأنى تؤفكون فالق الإصباح وجعل الليل سكنا والشمس والقمر حسبانا ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم وهو الذي جعل لكم النجوم لتهتدوا بها في ظلمات البر والبحر قد فصلنا الآيات لقوم يعلمون وهو الذي أنشأكم من نفس واحدة فمستقر ومستودع قَدْ فَصَّلْنَا الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمٍ يَفْقَهُونَ
MashaAllah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. As we heard these verses, talks about some of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But these signs are for those who have knowledge, for them to benefit. From those who have understanding, they comprehend upon these signs. And that's why the verses end with these characteristics of the human beings, those who would benefit from the signs. Therefore, not everybody would benefit from it, except those who have the proper understanding, for those who reflect and take a lesson from it so that they would live their life accordingly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked in these verses about how the plants comes out from the seed and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that creates this. And this is a miraculous thing that we see on a daily basis, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that brings those who are alive from dead and vice versa. And this is something that, as we see clearly, life itself is being established every day. And even sometimes a child is born from a dead mother, or you know, things of that nature. So this is all by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the heavens and the earth, for Him to be worshipped alone. The same thing with the morning, with the evening. And these are signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sun and the moon, everything in its orbit, everything in its, by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the Almighty, the Unknower subhanahu wa ta'ala. The stars are mentioned for people to be guided when they're traveling as one of the benefits to be benefited from the stars during the night, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made these ayat for those who have knowledge, and great sciences can be as a result of this creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The creation of the human beings from one soul, and the father of all of the human beings is Adam alayhi salam, and how that everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of that is by the power of Allah. So just examples, signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who have the proper understanding, for those who reflect upon them. Then we continue inshallah ta'ala with the same, or the next set of verses from verses number 99 and 100, and with Sheikh Mas'ud Abdullah, please recite for us inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وهو الذي أنزل من السماء ماء فأخرجنا به نبات كل شيء فأخرجنا به نبات كل شيء فأخرجنا منه خضرا نخرج منه حبا متراكبا ومن النخل من طلعها قنوان دانية وجنات من أعناب وجعلوا لله شركاء الجن وخلقهم سبحانه وتعالى عما يصفون.
MashaAllah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Very nice recitation. And as we heard, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining and clearly the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who's the one that brings down the rain for people to sustain a life? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, this is a sign that is repeated throughout the Quran, and there's a great wisdom behind it. It's something that is repeated in the lives of the human beings many times, but many people, they don't reflect upon this. They don't take the lesson from it, for them to humble themselves to the power of Allah, and for them to take this as an evidence of the hereafter. The resurrection is in the same manner. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down the the water from the skies, and the plants comes out from the earth. All of that is by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned more than one time, فَأَخْرَجِنَا بِهِ, that He's the one that brought out by this water the plant from the earth. And also, فَأَخْرَجِنَا مِنْهُ خَضِرًا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings out of it the green and so on. And how the grains and the seed, all of that is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the palm trees and the gardens of grapes and olives and pomegranates and all of these things look alike and it's not really the same. They look alike, they are receiving the same nutrition from the earth. They're all irrigated with the same water, but the different taste and the different looks and so on. All of that to show the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For people, again, for what? انظروا إلى ثمره إذا أثمر وينعي. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the human beings to look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created and the fruits that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, for people to look in the right way. And that is to make them believers. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكُمْ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. These signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should lead the person to al-Iman, to faith. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is able to do all things, and for a reason, for a specific reason, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And then after seeing this and seeing the power of Allah, then you see how evil are those who associate partners with Allah. These images, whether it's from jinn that they worship besides Allah, or anything that they worship besides Allah, they have no power whatsoever. They're not the creators of all of what we heard. And people would invent lies about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a son, or the angels are the daughters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the disbelievers they claimed. And glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the most exalted above all of what they attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing is the like of Allah. And this is the same with every matter of shirk, again, associating partners with Allah, which is something that we see as a common thing with these verses that talks about the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll go on, inshallah ta'ala, with more verses, but this time we'll go to Surah Al-A'raf and verse number 54 all the way to verse number 58, and with the reciter, Sheikh Fardeen Raufi. Please go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. إن ربكم الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش يغشي الليل والشمس والقمر والنجوم مسخرات بأمره ألا له الخلق والأمر تبارك الله رب العالمين ادعوا ربكم تضرعا وخفية إنه لا يحب المعتدين ولا تفسدوا في الأرض بعد إصلاحها ودعوه خوفا وطمعا إن رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين وهو الذي يرسل الرياح بشرا بين يدي رحمته حتى إذا أقلت سحابا ثقالا فأنزلنا به الماء فأخرجنا به من كل الثمرات كذلك نخرج الموتى لعلكم تذكرون والبلد الطيب يخرج نباته بإذن ربه والذي خبث لا يخرج إلا نكدا كذلك نصرف الآيات لقوم يشكرون.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Very nice recitation. And again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stating these facts and these universal signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it is your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that created the heavens and the earth in 6 days. And then he rose over the arsh, the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the day and the night, as we heard, keeps on being repeated in the Quran, the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sign of the night and the sun of the sign of the day, and how the sun and the moon and the stars all are under the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are being sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill their job. None of them, none of the creation of Allah has a say whatsoever. They're all in state of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after mentioning these signs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in verse number 54, as always been the case with the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the universal ones, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ, that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belong the creation and also the order. That means He's the only creator, and therefore He's the only one for people to receive His orders in full submission, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one that has the right to say this is halal and this is haram, for people to establish the orders of Allah, to forbid whatever He forbade, to make permissible what He made permissible, to make obligations of what He made obligations, and so on. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is glorified. He's the Lord of the Alameen. And then ordering, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordering the believers, ordering the human beings to embrace the truth and to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to have this intense dua and to make it not to raise the voice and so on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love those who transgress. So has the relationship between seeing the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the dua and the ibadah and the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are never separated. And warning against spreading corruption on the face of earth. If you truly believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not spread corruption on the face of earth after it's been rectified by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And calling also the believers to worship Allah, to invoke Allah, to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, khawfan wa tama'a, out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and hoping for the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because indeed the mercy of Allah is very near to those who are muhsineen, to those who are good doers. And that's also encouraging us and relating all of these physical signs to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with al-ihsan, with goodness, if you want to receive the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. More of the signs of Allah, He is the one, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that send the winds. And it brings all kinds of glad tidings to the people from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these skies that carries the water, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send it to whatever land that He wills, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the rain will come down. And as a result of that, the fruits and the vegetables and the like of that will come out as a result of this. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the wisdom behind this and why it's created in such a way. كَذَلِكَ نُخْرِجُ الْمَوْتَى لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, this is how we bring out the dead, so that you would have a reminder of this. So if someone wants to know how the dead will be resurrected, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing the miraculous resurrection every day, when people would see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created things from nothing, and how the rain and the vegetation and the fruits and so on. So this is basically the signs of Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us to reflect upon, that would guide us into the belief in the matters of pillars of al-Iman, into worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, establishing the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a result of reflecting upon these signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We continue inshallah ta'ala with more verses from Surah Al-A'raf, and this time from verse 171 to 174. Surah Al-A'raf, verse 171 to 174. And Sheikh Irshad Shahad, please recite for us inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ نتقنا الجبل فوقهم كأنه وَكَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ.
MashaAllah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for this nice recitation. And as we heard these verses in Surah Al-A'raf, after the mention of the story of Musa alayhi salam with Bani Israel, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about some of the things that happened to them, and because of their rebellious nature against the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and reminding the human beings that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the covenant from all of the sons of Adam before they were created, from each and every one of us. And this is basically referring, as the ulama they say, to what's present in the fitrah, in the innate of each and every person. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Lord of the Alameen. Alastu bi rabbikum. That means no one whatsoever on the face of earth that would deny the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unless this is based on stubbornness and not based on one's innate. This is something that we are created with. That's why the messengers of Allah, when they were sent to their people, they were not convincing them or addressing them or inviting them to believe in the existence of Allah. This is already given to them. But rather, they're calling the people to worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the disbelievers, they associate partners with Allah and so on. But someone to deny the existence of Allah, this is something against human nature. It's against how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. So this matter is mentioned very clearly in the Quran, so that nobody will come on the Day of Judgment and to say that they were heedless about this and they didn't know. And that's why once the messengers are being sent, there's no excuse once the matter becomes very clear, because again, it's something that a person would find how the truth is overpowering, that he has to submit himself. But why people turn away from the truth? Arrogance, stubbornness, whatever, diseases in the heart, but the matter has been made very clear. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning the human beings, because these signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, the physical ones, and it's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that purpose, for people to see that everything is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone finds something under the earth that is very well decorated, something very nice, very beautiful, people would immediately think, who's the one that made this? Nobody would ever think of something else. And the same way with regards to the earth and the heavens and the skies and all of these signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, who is the one that created all of this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For what reason? For people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. That's why the message of the messengers of Allah, people are in need of it more than they need food and drink, because this is the life of their souls, this is the purpose of their life. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He established the ayat, as it's mentioned in verse number 174, وَكَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained the ayat and the signs from Him in so much details. For what reason? For people to return to Allah. They return to Allah in this life with repentance, humbling themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala physically in the day of resurrection. So the importance of details that are mentioned about these signs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned them. And it is not just that He ordered the people to reflect upon them, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned them and repeated them in the Quran, throughout the entire Quran, for people to see these signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and to be warned against the nations before, how they rejected the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after the matter has been made clear to them. Because of the time, we'll go to break and come back again inshallah ta'ala with more verses to be recited about the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please stay tuned, we'll be right back. Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulullah. Welcome back, and still with some verses in Surah Al-A'raf that we are listening to, focusing on the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, because that's also from the signs of Allah, the sunnah of Allah, the ways Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have certain ways that never changes on the face of earth. And this is what we're trying to focus to benefit from inshallah ta'ala. It brings all kinds of benefits for us to humble ourselves to Allah, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, to strengthen our iman, to know how things are on the face of earth, so that we do not panic, we do not get terrified when we're not supposed to understand and to believe that everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala, and with verses in Surah Al-A'raf 175 to 177, from 175 to 177, and Sheikh Mustafa Ahmadi, please go ahead and recite for us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم واتل عليهم نبأ الذي آتيناه آياتنا فانسلخ منها فأتبعه الشيطان فكان من الغاوين ولو شئنا لرفعناه بها ولكنه أخلد إلى الأرض واتبع هواه فمثله كمثل الكلب إن تحمل عليه يلهث أو تتركه يلهث القصص لعلهم يتفكرون.
These verses, as we heard, talks about something or an example that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. Regardless of the name of the individual, the name is not mentioned, and then the books of the tafsir, you would find all kinds of things. But the point here is, and what's important for us to understand, is to understand the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about someone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the ayat of Allah. He had the knowledge, he had the means, he understood exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from him. But instead of holding fast to it, he took himself away from it. He deviated himself. The shaitan followed him, and as a result of that, he was among those who are wicked and corrupted, and those who turned away from the orders of Allah. And everything is by the will of Allah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, he would not make him so much attached to this world and to follow his desire. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the example of the dog. Whatever the dog, he's always having this extreme attitude when it comes to the breathing, how we see how the dog, they breathe very heavily, whether they are working hard or not working hard. And this is how to mention the stories on the Quran. The stories of the Quran are mentioned for a great reason, and that is for people to learn from it. To learn what happened to those who deny the ayat of Allah. Those who oppose the truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows their affairs in the Quran, and one of which is in Surah Al-A'raf. There are many stories mentioned in the Surah. The story of Nuh alayhi salam, and Prophet Hud and Salih, and Prophet Shu'aib, and then the story of Musa alayhi salam. All of these stories for what reason? For people to reflect. So at-tafakkur, or to reflect and to think about the outcome of actions. The same way with the universe of science, to show the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. And those who deny the ayat of Allah, those who disbelieve after the matter has been made clear to them, there is nothing worse than them. And they are wrong doing towards their own selves, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with verses 178 to 180 from Surah Al-A'raf, and with Sheikh Mas'ud Abdullah. Please go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. من كالأنعام ولله الأسماء الحسنى فادعوه بها وذروا
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Very nice recitation. And as we heard the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, that whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, then he is the one that is guided. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lead astray, no one can guide. So therefore, the loser ones are the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not guide. A benefit in understanding this concept that guidance is in the hands of Allah, that a person would only turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone seeking guidance. Guidance is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And therefore, we don't need to seek guidance from anyone. And then when we seek guidance from the Quran and the way the Prophet ﷺ, this is the way of guidance, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that guides the heart to be upon the truth. And that's why the hearts need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Also, the verses talked about how, or the characteristics of the people of the Hellfire, which is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the signs of Allah, showing the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the face of earth, that they have hearts, but they don't comprehend. They don't use it to reflect upon the signs of Allah for them to be guided. They have eyes, but they don't really see with their eyes the truth from the falsehood. They have ears, but they're not listening to the truth. They're acting like the cattle, even though the cattle, they are in state of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But these human beings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them these senses for what reason? For them to see the truth, for them to reflect upon the ayat and the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that they would worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. But instead, if they just use these senses to live the life of the cattle and the animals, they eat and they drink and they enjoy themselves and that's it, then there is nothing for them in the hereafter except the hellfire. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the verse. And they are the ones in state of forgetfulness. So the people need to worship Allah, invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His names and attributes, and to turn away from those who disbelieve or alter the meanings of them. They will face the outcome of their actions. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with more of the verses of Surah Al-A'raf. And this time from verse number 185 to verse number 187. And with Sheikh Fardin Raufi, please go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Awalam yanzuru fi ملكوت السماوات والأرض وما خلق الله من شيء وأن عسى قد اقترب أجلهم فبأي حديث بعده يؤمنون من يضلل الله فلا هادي له يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها قل إنما علمها عند ربي لا يجليها لوقتها إلا هو قل إنما ثقلت في السماوات والأرض لا تأتيكم إلا بغتة يسألونك كأنك حفي عنها قل إنما علمها
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Very nice recitation about the signs of Allah and condemning actually the disbelievers or those who are heedless. أَوَلَمْ يَنْظُرُوا فِي مَلَكُوتِ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ Don't they see and look into the sovereignty of the heavens and the earth and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created of all kinds of things, and that maybe their ajal or their limit or their life span is something very near, death is very near to them. So what else after all of this would they believe? Meaning condemning those who see with their own eyes the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they don't believe, they don't act accordingly. So seeing is one thing, but is it benefiting? Does it benefit their hearts? Do they humble themselves? Do they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone? And therefore again, guidance is in the hands of Allah. And if people do not take these signs seriously from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if they don't think, they don't reflect, then they should not blame anyone but their own selves. And instead of them focusing on what's benefiting for them and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, they start asking all kinds of questions that is of no benefit to them. When is the hour, this and that, they ask and they become in haste for the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it clear that nobody knows when the hour is going to be established except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not even the angel that carries the trumpet that it's once he's ordered to blow in it, everybody will die and everybody will be resurrected afterwards. He does not even know when is that going to be. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ Most people, they do not know about this, about the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The believers, they do, because this is in the book of Allah. The knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything. Nothing is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all of these are signs from Allah on the face of earth for people to reflect upon. And we'll go on, inshallah ta'ala, with the last set of verses to listen to the recitation, inshallah ta'ala, and to try to reflect upon the meaning. Same surah, Surah Al-A'raf, verses 189 to 192. From 189 to 192. And with Sheikh Irsad Shahat, please go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وجعل منها زوجها ليسكن إليها فلما تغشاها حملت حملا خفيفا فمرت به فلما أثقلت دعوا الله ربهما لئن آتيتنا صالحا لنكونن من الشاكرين فلما آتاهما صالحا جعلا له شركاء فيما آتاهما فتعالى الله عما يشركون أيشركون ما لا يخلق شيئا وهم يخلقون ولا يستطيعون لهم نصرا ولا أنفسهم ينصرون.
إن شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Very nice recitation. And again, as we hear in these verses, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is stating a fact here that He's the one subhanahu wa ta'ala that created us from one soul, from Adam alayhi salam. وَجَعْلَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا. And from the wife of Adam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human beings one after the other, one generation after the other. And the sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that one of the signs of Allah is this fact that there are men and women, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have this tranquility between the husband and the wife to the husband. This is all from the signs of Allah. It's mentioned here, it's mentioned in other parts of the Quran, and how that as a result of this relationship and the offsprings, those who would come as a result of that, all of that is from the signs of Allah. And that when people are desperate, they want the provisions from Allah, they want to have offsprings and children and so on, and they would make conditions that they will be among those who are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide for them someone that is righteous. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed that upon them, they would take partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Usually this verse, many people, they talk about the in the explanation of it, that this is refers to Adam alayhi salam, which is not authentic. It's not authentic narration whatsoever. And this is mentioned in general like this, for anyone that falls under this category of evil doing, in which a person, instead of being grateful to Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed His favor upon him, they would take idols or images to be worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to call names of shirk and the like of this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is exalted above all what people do or associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, the creation of Allah is mentioned to expose shirk and associating partners with Allah. أَيُشْرِكُونَ مَا لَا يَخْلُقُ شَيْئًا وَهُمْ يُخْلَقُونَ. How can they associate partners with Allah? Who are those images or idols that they are worshipping besides Allah? They don't create anything. Even if it's a prophet of Allah, even if it's Jesus, the son of Mary, even whatever prophet of Allah or human beings or images or whatever there is, they did not create anything. So how can they take them as partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَهُمْ يُخْلَقُونَ. And they are the ones that are being created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore the creator, if people reflect upon the meanings of the creator, He's the only one worthy of worship. And the creation of Allah, they do not create because they are creation of Allah. And if they are creation of Allah, that means they are by default in need of the creator of the heavens and the earth. So they are not to be worshipped. As simple as it sounds, this is the truth. And this is how the message of the truth and the message of all of the prophets of Allah. And then the verses keeps on coming afterwards, talking about the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala versus these idols that are creation of Allah. They have no power whatsoever. They cannot help anyone. They cannot even help their own selves if someone try to harm them and so on. So this is a reminder and a call for us to be humble and to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, to be upon the truth and to be proud of the truth that we carry, which is present in the Quran and in the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we'll continue inshallah ta'ala next time with more verses that talks about the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the universal signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for people to humble themselves and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So till next time, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you all. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.